You know what's so cool about the Big Souls YouTubers is they don't even need an intro. These guys are so self-assured that they just drop straight into their content without saying so much as
Hey!
Maybe I'll give it a try. Maybe not. Let's just get into things. Every patch that FromSoft has released keeps making monumental changes that completely redefine how we play the game. One of those major changes in 1.08 was the massive nerf to the heavy thrusting sword. The poise damage was reduced from 97 on a standing R1 to 83, and the jumping R1 was reduced from a guaranteed poise break to 124. This alone is a major change in the weapon, as it now has inconsistent poise break against people with high poise. The hit stun of jumping attacks was also reduced by one stage for both the jumping R1 and the jumping R2, which means that the weapon lost its ability to true combo off of jump attacks, and counter damage was reduced across all weapons. With all these things together, the weapon functions very differently than it did in the past. But does that mean that the weapon is really dead? I would argue that the weapon was already overtuned. Having a guaranteed true combo out of jumping attacks gave the weapon a lot of pressure that allowed it to be very aggressive. But even with the loss of the true combo, the weapon still has insane pressure with its fast jump attacks, range, and having the most root motion out of any weapon in its running R2. As someone that mains the heavy thrusting sword, I would say that this is a fair and balanced adjustment. The one thing that From really missed on was lowering the poise damage on the jumping R1. Other weapons of similar class, even power stance small weapons, have a guaranteed poise break on their jump attacks. Losing that poise damage really weakens this weapon against opponents with high poise, especially when compared to other weapons like power stance, street swords, and spears. Okay, so the weapon is nerfed, how do we work around it? To shore up the poise damage, there's always the option to run Cragblade to guarantee a poise break. Spacing becomes your priority, and you can't monkey mash into people. Oh no, how tragic. Yep, you have to play smarter. Use your angles, use different jumps, use your range, mix up your attacks. HTS has one of the most diverse and aggressive toolkits out of any weapon. Use your Ashes of War to make up for your deficits, Flaming Strike for corner pressure, Piercing Fang for whiff punishing, Raptors to get around your ridiculously long recovery times. You have options, you just have to use them. For the rest of the video, I'll be showing clips on how I've been working around these changes and trying my best to make the weapon work. Make sure you stick around till the end of the video, because I'll be fighting in a 1v1 combat ordeal against one of the best HTS players in the entire game. If you enjoy the video, be sure to like and subscribe, and let me know down in the comments if you found the video helpful at all, and what I can do to improve in the future.
Wait,
Ugh.